Welcome to Backseat Blackout. And today
we're going to the Think Tank, which is located in
Birmingham
Millennium Point. Yeah. Up there.
Into
the Think Tank. And it's like a science museum. So
yeah. All I know is that there's a lot of thinking. So we'll have to think about what we think about it. So.
Thought we'd go and get a shot. Going to the sea life centralizer, so we'll do that on a separate blog, like
have a little swim.
Just to have it, you know, cut it down a bit. Yeah. As you can see, all different kind of some bloke with I don't know what it is, was it?
A rock laser cutter.
But yeah, we'll go and get our tickets, £13, it's not too bad. I think it's like extra £1.50 for the Emporium. It's like a massive stars. I'm not sure, it's like overhead theatre. It's got like all stars in there or something. Looks cool.
Stars in Europe.
I need to be careful because on the Warwick Castle vlog, I kept pulling my hand over the mic.
The mic?
Yeah, cool. So I've got to be careful of that. So,
yeah.
Right, see you in there, get our tickets. First impressions?
Good.
Got these groovy wristbands.
Futuristic wristbands, man.
What shall we go?
We've got planetarium. I'm not too sure what it is yet. I think we go upstairs and go in space and float around.
Well, it's only £13 entry and £1.50 extra for the planetarium. It's like a 24-minute show.
It's stocker
thing. We'll let you know later anyway, but we've got all different.
Comment below if you know what this is.
I think they don't know what that is, do you reckon?
Yeah, but do that now.
Oh. No one knows. Yeah, there's a digger over here, we're gonna have a look at a digger in a minute. Right, she's looking at modified food and sounds looking down here. We're catching a bit, if anything interesting we'll let you know.
See you in a bit.
Welcome to a lesson, Chris. Just a general lesson.
Episode 1, traffic lights. Can a traffic light tell if you're waiting? Some can. Like this one here. They've got sensors in the road. An induction loop made from a few turns of wire. Yeah, I'm totally not reading off the side. So basically, when you cross the road, you'll pick up that person's there, and you won't get run over, so... That's how traffic lights work, I believe.
So this is
a segment. It's got Davies' Digger Services.
POV.
Right, what are we going to do?
Go on, Andy Rumney, teach him some things.
So I'm going to get that over there and bring it over to the road.
That is to say, two tons times 1 meter distance. Turning or leverage force, say 2 meters.
The
turning force exerted by the half ton leverage is 5 meters from the distance.
Does it exert a 10 out of 10.
Performance. 10 out of 10.
Right, then.
The controls are a bit slow, but Chris's turn.
Turn.
Oh, you break it.
There we go.
Oh, Chris.
POV.
I need to scoop it a bit better.
Keep me alone.
Well, he's got. That's it, you got him? He's doing better than me anyway. Oh, he's got 5 balls, I think. 5 balls.
Let's get it over here. Ready? Let's do it. POV.
You drop it.
balls. There's two balls trapped in the actual. I think I did all right.
Yeah, you did all right. You did better than me, anyway.
Yeah. So think tank can control cranes and
diggers.
I don't know if he'll get you a qualification in crane work, but it's a start.
Yeah, it's a start.
We've also found some more skulls, which, right here, you've got the likes of a fallow deer,
which braves a dolphin.
All right, let's Chris give you a lesson.
All right, Chris, give us a lesson.
The fallow deer browses on fresh leaves and shoots. The chisel-shaped front teeth nibble off the leaves. The rigid back teeth grind down the hard plant matter.
A bit of dolphin. Look at the size of them teeth. Look at them teeth.
Does anyone know anyone with teeth that do that?
All them there.
Right, I think that's the only one.
That skull's been chipping away, so look at that.
Ooh. Oh, we've got a human skull, yeah.
He's missing his two front teeth.
Jezza.
That's all he wants for Christmas, doesn't he?
Yeah.
He's been on Jezza a few times, isn't he? He's missing teeth.
This is a crocodile, alligator, if you want, whatever you want to say.
Oh, the size of this one.
Little teeth at the side.
Ooh.
Side of things there.
There's some big teeth.
That is a zebra, zebra.
Oh, we have a question.
Oh.
In the comment below, if a zebra is white with black stripes or black with white stripes.
Good idea, isn't it? Is a zebra a black with white stripes or white with black stripes?
Or nothing at all.
Comment
just
below.
Not exist.
Comment below. We'll catch you in a bit. Well, I'm going to move on to another place and do what's around, aren't we?
Yep. Let's see what's happening.
I'm a five-starter. Twisted five-starter.
So what happens if I
just... You like playing with that?
It's a good little tool, isn't it? Ah.
You look around, you move the little ball on the table, and as you move it round, it shows you...
You can dance.
You can dance. Head pop. But it shows you what different kinds... Move it to the side, Chris.
You're quick.
Oh, yeah. So it gives you facts. Cool little feature, isn't it? Anyway, we're moving down here. There's all like sea fossils and all that kind of stuff. Just different animal stuff in there.
All sorts of stuff. All sorts of interesting stuff. Sea urchins, mollusks.
Smarter.
Well, remember. Anyway. What else is that? Let's have a
look. Welcome. James Paul Beattie in the making.
A length of DNA is a meaningful message, but it's also a lot of junk. A tune is buried in the sound mix. Switch off the junk notes and just tune left.
Just that.
The end, that's all I want to know. Oh, it starts again.
Oh, I'm
back. Right.
Yeah, so ThinkTank, it's got, as you see, just, it's got all the animals, stuffed animals, and they're really cool. Here now, they've got like little games, they've all different facts about the human body, as you can see. I'm not sure they've got needles or something, but over there, we've got a brain, Chris is looking at and reading upon.
He's pretty gruesome, and they've
got a hand sign. But yeah, as you seen at the start, there's loads of interactive stuff. This is literally not even a quarter of the stuff to see. We've got another level upstairs. We've got that show that paid extra £1.54. Should be worth it. Extra £1.50.
Honestly, the best thing I've seen so far is actually getting an in-depth look at the human brain. It is quite scary to think that's inside our heads. But we can't film it. So
obviously, I think upstairs on the top level is like the future. This level here now is
biology.
Yeah, I think it's today's world. And so downstairs is like old fashioned, so there'll be like old fashioned vehicles and all that kind of stuff. And there's some activities outside as well, so we'll take you out and have a look at that as well. Sally's playing this game. Oh no, she's looking at the brain as well. But yeah.
And this is what goes through Scott's mind every day.
What? Through my mind?
Yeah.
Very true.
Yeah, and that's what it sounds like sometimes.
We'll get some more cinematics for you, and we'll head upstairs and look at that show. I don't think I can film in there, but we'll give you our review afterwards. Toodaloo.
Toodaloo.
Stretch your arms. Stretch your arms. That's it. Stretch your arms.
Stretch your arms.
Stretch your arms.
Stretch your arms, Scott.
Cool.
Well done, everyone.
We're inspecting the human body.
It's
a nose. It's like a bogey. Bogey's like, you can feel like hairs at the top.
That is nasty.
I feel like hairs at the top, and when you're just in there, obviously it's a man's hand. How do you do? You've got the human eyeball, and you've got the eyelashes. Yeah, you've got the brain again. Chris obsessed with the brain. Got the ear. You've got the tongue. Press a button to start. Oh god. Right, you've got coffee, crisps, lemon. Honey and mushrooms. It says press a button. I don't know how this is going to work, so I'm going to press a good one first. I'm going to press coffee. Coffee's gone. I think it travels.
I want something sour.
I want something sour.
I want something sour. So let's give him lemon.
That's sour. I want something bitter.
Bitter.
Lager.
Crisps. That's not bitter.
I want something salty.
Salty. That's crisps.
You want something salty.
That's salty.
I want something umami.
What umami. Let's give him a mushroom.
That's umami.
What is umami?
Sweet. Honey.
That's sweet.
Oh, he's an idiot. Right. We've also got here. Yeah. Sure. Let's try pan. A bit crap in there.
Hate in the tongue.
Right, we'll see what else there is. Catch you in a minute.
Yeah, man.
Pretty good area, not gonna lie, but.
Yeah, although I get the hard to stroke the hand and slap it for some reason. Stroke the hand gently. Don't do anything.
It does. He goes, ah, and it sends something to the brain.
Oh.
Slap it.
I don't even know.
Sausages.
Of course, they've got them.
Oh, cool. Frankfurt.
It's over here.
Can you actually smell these?
Fish makes you grow strong and healthy.
Strong and windy.
What's that?
Chips give you energy, but don't eat them all the time.
Don't eat chips.
Baked beans give you energy and make you strong and windy.
And windy. Jog loads.
Burgers help make you strong.
Solid energy for running and swimming. Too much sugary chocolate makes you fat.
Yes. So keep away from sugary chocolate.
Right, we're going to our show now upstairs. So what we'll do is we'll go, we'll watch it, we'll come back and we'll let you know how it is. Yeah, we'll give you a review. Extra £1.50 it is on top of your entry charge. So we'll look at that now. And being car, I was up crossing. Yeah, but I'm going to get the lift up, we'll let you know how it is, and we'll see you after the show. Cross here.
Cross here.
Hang on, let's get in some voice.
Is this a door?
I know, it's dark, isn't it? Oh, there's loads of light down there. Here we go, that's better. Chris, just been in that show thing.
Planetarium, I think, Cosmic Safari. It was good, it was alright.
It was alright, wasn't it?
I wish it was a bit more immersive, to be honest, because it was a lot of talking, a lot of predicting what's out there kind of thing, but I'd have preferred just like no talking, music. Just going through the solar system, shots of the planet. It's a bit dated as well, didn't you think? Like the CGI was a bit old.
Yeah, I didn't really fancy it, mate. It wasn't the best.
Yeah,
I think the one at Leicester, the Space Centre, a lot better. But this one, I didn't really rate it that much. Yeah, there was a lot of talking on there. You had the subtitles at the bottom, I just couldn't stop looking at them. You know what I mean?
It was a bit distracting, but if they made it a bit brighter, it's a bit dark for it.
Yeah.
And maybe made it a bit more clearer.
A bit more realistic.
4K, trying to produce 4K in a planetarium.
Just a bit more realistic. It just looks a bit, what's the word?
Dated.
Yeah.
Dated is definitely the word.
Anyway, we're going to see what we can find now.
Yeah. Backseat blackout rating of...
I'll give it a 4.
Yeah. I'd say it's pretty dry. Pretty dry. So, see you in a bit. See a bit of magic, backseat magic.
Wingardium Leviosa, boom!
Magic?
That's how you become a wizard.
It's walk and talk.
It's walk and talk. So, what do you think of the think tank, man, Scott?
I think it's.
I think you're a bloody thief, that's all.
I think it's really good. Some good little elements, some good sections.
This section in particular is really nice.
Yeah, it's really good. That's a cool set. You can't really see nothing.
Lots of different
tour models and all that kind of stuff. It's really good. This is over here, the whale. Chris. Press once.
Oh god.
Oh, the whale's moving. You can't see nothing. There's not much lighting around here.
It's very
steep. What do you think of that?
I thought it smoked. What the?
Yeah.
That looks like something out of Bioshock Infinite. You ever played that? It's very steampunk.
Cool. Good stuff.
This is why I don't like mushrooms. Mushrooms. Them are a different kind of mushroom now, people have them there.
You got the octopus?
Where's the fish?
Now we're not going to see, we're not have to see those sentry yet?
Yeah, that's a teaser, that is.
A teaser.
Teaser for the next vlog.
Teaser. Produce some milk.
Some nice milk.
Yeah, so let's have a feel of the camp.
Bit rough.
Iron.
I still will.
Loving this car though.
It's a mini. Not sure what I'm in. I'm sure. Oh no, no, I'm sure already. The gear's secure.
This level is more about transport, just different kind of stuff in the past, you know, not too far in the past, but that was different kind of stuff, and how technology has evolved. Like here we've got all different kind of leads and plugs, we've got radios, old clocks, what else have we got? We've got an old fashioned room here, cool little stuff, saucepans. Don't know what I'm saying now.
That's copper.
Well, it's hot, it's quite warm though. Iron, aluminium and stainless steel.
Well, I think what you do is you put the one there like that and you heat them up.
Got a fridge. You want a fridge? Yeah, got stuff.
It's a lamp on.
Some cool stuff around here.
I'm sure I think that means as well. Obviously so sound something.
Did you just melted things?
No what?
Melted what? I'll let you know what's going on in a minute.
Oh, sorry.
Oh. Backseat mechanic services from Scott.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, good. There's no one over here. Position the camera.
Yeah.
I get what's going on, to be honest. Oh, yeah.
Press the start button.
Position the cam so the pistons rise in the normal order.
Let's go.
It's like a Doctor Who special down here. We've got back in time.
For Mr. Harry Rawdon. Nice train over here.
What train is this one? Find out.
46235 is Harry. If that means anything, we'll go up and have a look. But hey, oh, that was a bit of a sun there. Yeah.
They've even got the sun in the
museum. Just for Harry. I think you gotta go up that side, Harry, do you? What do you think about this train, Chris?
Very nice. I'm not a train enthusiast, but
it
I could imagine this being quite an interesting thing to look at if you are a train enthusiast. I don't know. You tell me.
Harry will tell you.
Yeah.
Yeah. As you can see, we're walking up now. And you can have a look around the old different signs, all that kind of good stuff. Nice to have a look in there. Pick this up. That's where obviously where all the coal goes.
I think.
I'm right.
Don't touch. No, please do not claw and not touch. You can touch the brakes.
Confusion. Oh, you got it. Come on. How weak is that?
Look at this.
It's everywhere. As soon as you get it moving,
it's got.
I swear to God, I bet Soph could do it.
You reckon?
So, passing the car, I bet you could.
Right, these two idiots can't push this. Go and sit in there. And you sit in there as well. Bet your father could do it with one hand.
It's rough. Right there, you got a bite.
One hand. Can't even push it, both of them. One hand, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That's one hand. That's one hand. Do it with one hand, with two of them in. I couldn't even push with two hands, wouldn't it push me in? Silly. Too strong, you know. Right, I'm going to give you another POV in a minute. I'm going to hand you over to Mr. Chris Davenport.
I've been given this.
Oh, yeah.
Gano!
Gano! Backers as well.
Yeah, yeah. Go on, Scott, put your back into me.
Yeah.
You like it?
It's effort. That's what it is. Come on then. You wanna go?
Go on then.
Have a go.
Effort.
It's effort. No, I'm standing in the road, yeah. And backwards are. How do you think of that?
No, that's good fun. It's alright.
Chris is wee. I'm getting one there.
Come on, Chris.
What you gonna do?
It's gonna balance on it. It's really awkward. You're doing lots of down here, a lot of these. That's it, they just hang. What are you?
Well, I've hooked it up, Tom. Drop to her. Top, mate. Oh, it's not safe. This isn't safe. I'm at the top.
You're just gonna let go.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought it's gonna drop.
It's more intense than Apocalypse, Jason Manor.
What did it pull me?
Just pull yourself up.
Knock my head off, huh? Here we go, Sam. I don't think it's going to work.
Give it a go.
It's not going to work.
Just walk with it anyway, it'll be funny.
Oh my God, I'll call that upside down.
Matt.
X
extreme, extreme, extreme
power.
Here we go.
Power.
Power. Go on, let's see an example of power then, Scott. POV, shoulder. See this in action. So Scott's kinetic energy is bringing the weights up, but can he make it to the top? Cheating.
I'm going down to
it. You're going to do that.
What's that?
No, exactly. Oh.
That's like a solar panel.
Whoa.
Oh, it actually works as well. Look.
So with the solar light from the sun, we can now bring this weight up into the air. When the sun's off.
There's one there.
Watch, it's gonna drop,
See it at the top?
He's back.
Welcome to Scott's magic section of the vlog. Chris did this earlier, and now it's my turn with two big balls.
Wow! Oh!
Ready?
Whoa! Oh!
Now, we're trying to fit another ball in there.
Which does it work. Happen? It doesn't happen.
It doesn't happen.
Wow! But what happens if you flick the ball?
It's out. Magic.
Magic. Oh, I'm wet now.
What we're doing now is we're pumping up the water blaster.
Aiming it at the target.
At your front. What we're going to do is we're going to aim it up and shoot.
Ooh. I bet someone should stand over there for a laugh. Oh, what a shot. What a shot. What did you do?
Now, Chris is going to pop up. Sue's going to hold the camera. Rach is going to hold the camera.
Which way do I hold it that way?
What did you do? Pump it up. Pump it up. Turn it over. And just pump it through the
middle. Where's?
Now, just a little bit of water. Just one big pump. That's it.
So, I managed it. Hold on. Okay.
It's gone off. It's gone off.
The screen's probably just gone off. Still filming?
Yeah.
Still
now filming. It's
flashing. Oh, look at me.
A bit moist.
A bit moist.
Chris is a bit moist as well. Right, how did you buy ThinkTank overall?
This last bit's been really enjoyable, last little area.
Yeah.
It's all quite interesting, all quite good. Yeah, well, I'll probably bump to an 8 in terms of museums. There's a lot of things to do, a lot of interactive things to do.
Yeah, so this outside bit is really good. The bottom floor is really good as well, with all the old-fashioned cars and motorcycles and that kind of good stuff. The outside bit is terrific, really, on a sunny day. It's quite, it's quite enjoyable. Loads of stuff to do in there. We had that show, didn't we? What was it called?
Planetarium Cosmic Safari. Which was alright.
It's alright. So that was about a 6 out of 10. 5, 6 out of 10 would be a lot better, but
there's nothing exciting here at all.
What would you give ThinkTank overall?
It's between a 7 and an 8 out of 10, depending on how much you like science and history.
So I'm going to give it a 7.5 out of 10.
If you can't stand science and all that, aren't it boring, you might not have a good time here. But if you do really enjoy it, you'll have a blast.
Yeah, it is quite interesting, all the different kind of stuff they've got in here. Like, they've got a natural human brain, and cut it in half. That was pretty cool. Chris was...
I was engrossed in that. I was just looking at it, thinking, that's a brain, and that's what's making me so stupid at the moment.
It is good, but what I'm going to now head over to, what is it?
Sea Life.
Sea Life Centre, yeah, I forgot from it.
McDonald's?
yeah, probably go to Mackey's first, then go Sea Life Centre. We're not doing shout-outs this weekend, as Chris is doing that for next weekend, so...
I'll put a post up about
Get the winter, get the theme park season up and running again. But
we thought we'd do some little vlogs out and about, you know, just to fill the gaps in.
And as there's charges running low, we am powering this up.
Powering the bank.
Powering this bad boy.
So what we're going to do, we'll see you over at Sea Life Centre, where we've got some special guests joining us as well, haven't we?
Oh yes. So
we'll see who that is over there. Well, you will, we know who it is. And we'll catch you
in the sea.
In a bizzle.